Hey everyone, welcome back to our channel. I'm Yumesh Gupta. In today's video, we are going to talk about how we can reduce code duplication from our React app. Basically, we are going to take a look at a particular use case where, you know, we can focus on reusing logic or following the principle of dry, do not repeat yourself. So this is a pattern which I have seen over the years and had conversations with a couple of senior engineers. So I thought it would be good to share this with you all. I would definitely love to know your views on it. It would eventually help us write more concise components and eventually leading to smaller bundle size. So do share your views in the comments or maybe reach out to me on LinkedIn or Twitter. Also, before starting, it would be great if you could, you know, like, share or subscribe to the channel. It would help us a lot. It would motivate us to do a lot more. So let me give you a brief about what we have so far. So in this, we have a app component where we have two more components, one and two, which we are basically rendering. Let's see these components. So this is the component number one, where this is the common theme which we do in a lot of our components that, you know, we have a loading state, we have an error state, and we have some effect where we fetch the data. And if we have the data on, you know, response of the API, so as of now we are mocking get data. Assume that there is this function which provides us data, it makes an API call. So on the resolution, if there is an error, then we set the error. If there is if there is rejection, then we set the error. And if there is actual results, then we set the data. And if initially it is loading, then we show the loader. And if there is error, then we render the error. And last, if we have the data, then we just simply render out the entire data. This is the component one. And very similarly, we have the component two, where we exactly doing the same thing, fetching the data on mount, setting the loading state, setting the error state on error, and, you know, resetting the loading state here. The only difference is we are passing the type 2 so that we can have different data. But overall structure of the component is same, that we have a loading state, we have an error state, and we have items here. So now this is, so I'll first show you what is the output of these components. So basically initially we have loading, we have the data, and it just renders a list of items. This is the component one and this is the component two, as simple as that. So I have, you know, dumbed down the components just to show you a basic blueprint that this is the use case we have a lot of times, that we have some loading state, we have some data fetching, and then we show the error state or data rendering based on the resolution or rejection of the API. So we, and if you see in both of the components, we are essentially doing the same thing. That we have loading, we have a lot of overlap in the code, a lot of, you know, similar things happening. There are, you know, multiple ways to solve this, to, you know, make it more concise and abstract out the logic. But we are going to take a look at one particular way to do this. So let's build that. What if I want another code block down here after two? Let's say three. So I just create a new file, 3.js. I copy the entire code, I paste it. Let's just replace it with three. Let's parse the type as three here. Let's pass it type name. We go to app.js, we import three from components. Three, just render three here. So if you see down here, we have the third and we are getting the new data, but essentially we are just copying the code. And this is, you know, inefficient that we are doing the same thing. So let's, how can we abstract out the logic? How can we optimize this? There are a lot of ways to do this, but let's, in recent React, we have a very simple way to, you know, reuse logic, and those are custom hooks. So why not to utilize that? Let's say I have a component called await.js. In this, I am exporting a custom hook called usePromise. And in this usePromise, it's React. Now in our 3.js, we are in fact in all our components, we are maintaining these states. Let's extract out this first. So let's copy this. Let's paste this here. Use state. So we are going to move, data from or text code, basically code from our component to our custom hook, so that we can reuse it again and again. So let's initially set this as null. So now when we call this custom hook, we need all this data. So let's call it data, set data, and let's return this. So we are using data and error. Okay, now in our 3.js, this is going to break as of now. So let's commit up this for now. In this app, we can call, we can import first. We can import use promise from await component, and we can call it here. So we have use promise here. And now we know that since we are returning this object, that this promise would be an object that is going to give us three keys: loading, data, and error. The same things which we were getting here. So let's this and let's keep it as it is. So we abstracted out all the state from our component, all the loading, data, and error state, and we are returning the object and we are getting it in our promise. So if you see in this use effect, now let's talk about the blueprint first. What exactly is the functionality we are trying to achieve? So our aim is that initially we need to set the loading as true. We need to fetch the data. Then we have to set the data or set the error depending upon what is the outcome. And we have to set the loading as false again. And then we have to return the data. Now we did the return data part here. We initialize the states. Now we have to talk about data fetching, actual data fetching. Here in this component, we had this effect which was running on mount, and we were fetching, we were making a call to get data, which returns us a promise. And based on that, we were, you know, making our further decisions. We can do the same thing. We have to move this data fetching logic to our custom hook. So let's say if I have a function called processing, and in this function, I make the call to get data. We pass the type as 3, and we just simply pass this processing function here, and we invoke it. We can pass get data directly also, but I have wrapped it into a function. I'll explain later why I did that. So now this processing will call get data, and we will get a promise here. So let's go to our await component. In the custom hook, we have initial promise here. Similarly, what we were doing there, we could just use a use effect here, where on mount, first we will set the loading state as true. Then we have the promise. When this promise is resolved and we have the response, then we will set the response, or in this case set data as a response. If we have error, then we will set the error. And finally, when everything is done, then we can reset loading as Similarly, what we were doing there, that we had a promise. In this case, we were using a sync await, but here I'm using the then chain, that we were getting results. We were setting the items and setting the error on error, and we were resetting the loading state. Same we are doing here. So in this case, we can just simply remove this. So now we have the promise, and we can maybe use promise dot loading or promise dot error. And so we are error, we don't have items. So we can maybe simply do items would be if we have promise dot data and promise dot data dot items, then items in this case it would be results. We can use promise dot data dot results, or we can use empty. So we abstracted out the entire logic here, that we in this custom, in the custom hook on mount, we are setting the loading as true. We have initial promise. On resolution, we are setting the data. On error, we are setting the error. And on finally, we are setting the loading state. Now, if we go back to our, we can remove this also, we don't require that. We go to our app and we try to render this now. So it's working. We have the data. It's completely working fine, that we are able to render the our component. We abstracted out the entire logic. So we moved the entire logic, logic computation or data fetching to our custom hook. But how can we go one step further? This loading and error, rendering the loading component and error component is still there. Why can't we, abstract this off this also? Because this would be, we would be repeating this everywhere again and again in component one, two, the same. So let's do one thing, that in our await component, let's finally create the await component. It is going to be basically a wrapper component, which would provide us these functionality of, rendering the JSX. So what we have to do here is that if we have the loading, so let's talk about the blueprint here first. So if we have loading, then we will show loader. If we have error, then we will show error. If we have, let's say, data, then we will show the data, or we will render the output. In this case, it would be children because this would be a wrapper component, else we will return null. So we need all this data, loading, error, and data to here we have, if we have loading, then we will return here loading. If we have error, then we show error. And if we have data, then we show children. So how to use this now? So in this, we will import here, and we will wrap our component, our JSX with await. But now, since we know, like we talked about, that we need all this data, and we are already getting this from the promise, so we can simply pass this promise. If we pass this promise, and here we import it, promise and children, so this would be promise dot loading, be promise dot error, be promise dot data, and okay, there is, this would be else if we don't have anything, then we'll return null. Also, just as a sanity check, if we don't have any promise, then we will return null. So now if we go back here, we just remove this code. Let's see. Let me just refresh it. So we have three loading, where two and one and two are the same, using the old structure. And in the third, we have abstracted out everything. Let's remove this also. Let's keep it. So we have abstracted out the logic, and we have abstracted out loading and error state also. Now, if I want to create the fourth component, I would just copy this and or even if I want to create any other component, which I have to do something else, data fetching, or I have to show loading and error, then I don't need to think about loading and error state now. It will be automatically taken care of. And the result is that our component became more concise, and you don't have to worry about the mundane task of creating loading and error again and again. So we talked about how we can abstract out state and data fetching. We talked about how can we take care of default loading and error state. But what if we want to show a custom loader? We can take this a step further. So for now, let's say just I remove this so that we have more clarity in our 3.js. What if I have a somewhere I have a custom loader, and I want to show that I call it a custom loader. If you look right now, it's just showing the default loading state it was showing here. Now, but I want to, rather than showing a custom, default loading, I want to show a custom loader. So just like we were passing a promise, we can pass this as a prop loader, and in this we pass the custom loader. So in our await component, we can just simply get that prop, and we can call it custom loader. So in the loading state, if we have the loader, then we can call the custom loader. Okay, sorry. So if we have the custom loader, then we render the custom loader, else the default loading component. So here you can refresh again. We can see here that we have the custom loader, and this can be extended to error also. That let's say if you have a custom error component, we just copy this, we call this custom error, and this will be custom error. Here in this line number 26, we pass the error as custom error. And in our await component, just like we had loader, let's get this a bit, we can have a error as custom error. And just like this, we can copy this and paste here custom error. So in this case, we are not mocking the error as of now, so we're not seeing the error. But in the same principle applies here, that we are passing a custom error, and if there is we want to show a custom error component, then we can show it, and we can extend it to anything. I mean, if let's say you don't want to render children, you want to maybe you want to pass a function something like fulfilled, I might be spelling it wrong, and you want to pass some function to it, you can simply do that and get that prop here, and when you have data, you can call that function just like fulfilled. And you can, rather than returning children, you can call that function and pass the data promise dot data here, as simple as that. This could return a JSX or anything you like, it's up to you. So possibilities are endless in this case. It's up to you how want you want to optimize this, or you want to add more functionality. So this brings end to our video. We talked about abstracting the logic, creating this custom hook, use promise, managing all the state here, data fetching, setting, updating the state, and using that in our component. Then we talked about await component, how it can act as a wrapper component to our existing code, and It can take care of default loading or error states and so on. So this is one way to solve this problem. I'm sure there are many more ways out there. So I will definitely, would like to see your solution to this problem statement. And what do you think about this solution? Is it a overkill, or is it, too complex, or anything? It could be anything. Would love to hear your thought process on this and your views on this. So definitely reach out or maybe mention in comments. And once again, please do like, share, and subscribe. More amazing content like this would be coming out soon. We are planning the next set of videos. So, okay, have a nice day. Bye bye.